Hello everyone. Today in geography we will be starting with second chapter, latitudes and longitudes. Latitudes and longitudes. Here first we'll be discussing shape of the earth. As you all know, globe represents the earth. Spherical shape. But Earth is not exact sphere. It's not exact sphere. Earth is slightly misshapen. It is slightly misshapen because of its spinning. Because it rotates from west to east direction, it gets misshapen. And you can see it bulges around the equator. Because of the centrifugal force, it bulges around the equator and get flattened at the poles. At the poles, it get flattened. At the equator, it bulge a slight bit. So we call this Earth as having the shape of oblate spheroid. That is. Flattened sphere. And later, today the earth is considered a geoid. The earth is today considered as geoid. And what does it mean? It means that shape of the earth, shape of the earth is uniquely earth shaped. So, for Earth, we have defined one new term, geoid, which means shape of the Earth is uniquely Earth-shaped. Now, at the poles, it gets slightly flattened. At the equator, it gets slightly bulged. So, the slightly flattened polar diameter. Is about 12,714 kilometers, and this slightly bulging equatorial diameter is about 12,757 kilometer. So this difference, very slight difference between them, it is around 43 kilometers. If we take in, we calculate its percentage, will be around 0.3%. This difference is around 0.3%. The relative variation from the two spherical is very minute. That is only about 0.3%. And for most purposes, the Earth may be properly considered as a sphere. Indeed. It is more nearly perfect sphere than most of the sphere. For example, if you take basketball and compare with the Earth shape, the Earth will be more perfect as compared to the basketball. And if you consider the circumference around the equator, it is around 40,075 kilometers. So the circumference around the equator is 40,075 kilometers. Or we call it as equatorial circumference. We call this as, so equatorial circumference friends is about approximately 14,075 kilometers. Now we'll be discussing hemisphere. So if we draw an imaginary line around the earth such that it is equally distant from the north pole and the south pole. So this line will be called as equator. And this line divides the sphere into two equal halves and we call them as hemispheres. So this will be our north hemisphere or northern hemisphere we call. and it will be southern hemisphere. So equator divided the earth into two equal halves. On the north side of the equator is the northern hemisphere, and on the south side of the equator it is southern hemisphere. Similarly, 0 degree prime meridian and the 180 degree meridian, they divide the earth into two equal halves again, and this time it will be our eastern hemisphere, that is lying on the eastern sides of the meridian, eastern hemisphere, and it will be called our 0 degree, that is the prime meridian. And on the west side of the prime meridian, western hemisphere. So the equator and the prime meridian, it divides the earth into hemispheres. So we have got four hemispheres here. Next we'll be discussing directions. This is the east direction. The sun rises in the east, west, north, south. Now other direction, for example, in between north and east, and at an angle of 45 degree, it will be our northeast, northeast, and here it will be our northwest. Similarly in the south, southeast. Southeast, and here southwest. Furthermore, if you want to divide, here it will be east, northeast. Here, north, northeast. Similarly, here west, northwest. Here, north, northwest. So west, northwest, north, northwest. Similarly here, here will be south, we move from this side, south, southwest, south, southwest. Here from this side, west, southwest, west, southwest. Similarly here, south, southeast, and here from this side it will be east, southeast. So you can create this in book as well. So before discussing latitudes and longitudes in depth, let's have a brief idea about them. So we can pinpoint any location on earth using imaginary grid lines running from north to south and east to west. So latitudes measures how far, this is our equator, 0 degree, dividing the sphere into two equal halves. So latitude measures how far north or south the point is. So for example, this point you have to calculate its location. So how far this point is from the equator, either it's in north side or in the south side. So these are the imaginary lines here circling the earth. Similarly in southern hemisphere, so these are parallel to the equator, so these are latitudes. Similarly from north pole to south pole, these are longitudes. So we have drawn imaginary lines from east to west, and this line which passes from Royal Observatory in Greenwich, this is called as 0 degree longitudes or prime meridian. So So any location we can pinpoint using latitudes and longitudes. And for example, this is 0 degree longitude. So we can see the Earth is divided into grids. And using these longitudes and latitudes, we can find the location of any point on the Earth. Now we'll be discussing latitude. So first we'll define what does latitude mean. So it is an angular distance. And this angular distance can be in degrees, minutes, and seconds. Measured north or south of the equator. Measured north or south of the equator. So latitude is the angular distance. Angular distance in degrees, minutes, and seconds. Measured north or south of the equator. So here the reference is the equator. The equatorial plane will be reference. So for example, now we have to calculate latitude of this point P on the Earth surface. So what we do? We can project a line from the given point P on the Earth surface to the center of the Earth. This is the center of the Earth. We project a line from this point to the center of the Earth. And the angle between the line and the equatorial plane. The angle between the line and the equatorial plane is the measure of the latitude of the given point. So, for example, this is 30 degree. So, its latitude will be 30 degree. Now, since it lies in the northern hemisphere, it will be 30 degree north. For example, we have to calculate the latitude at this point, Q. So, we'll measure the angular distance from the equatorial point, equatorial plane. So, this will be, for example, it is 60 degree. So, it will be 60 degree. Since it lies in the northern hemisphere, it will be 60 degree north. So latitude can vary from 0 to 90 degree in the northern hemisphere or 0 to 90 degree in the southern hemisphere. And next, we'll be discussing parallels of latitude. So parallels of latitude. Parallels of latitudes are nothing but these are the lines. So parallels of latitude, for example, it is the line connecting all points of the same latitude. So at this point as well, it will be 30 degree. So all the points on this line, they will have the latitude of 30 degree. So parallels of latitude is having the same latitude. If we connect these all points, it will be a line parallel to the equator. So 0 degree parallel, this is the 0 degree parallel, it is called as equator. Parallel is called so because all lines of latitude, they are parallel to each other. So this parallel is parallel to equatorial 0 degree equator, and it is parallel to this line as well. So if we see from the top, or the top view we take, so we will be seeing the north pole. This will be our 0 degree, that is equator. And other parallels will be in this fashion. So each latitude is an imaginary circle. Each latitude is an imaginary circle parallel to the equator. These are parallel to the equator, and their center lies on the polar axis. On this polar axis, their center. For example, this circle we take, here the center will be there. And for this, here the center will be there for this circle. Here, the center of the Earth is the center of the equator. So these are called as parallels of latitudes. So for example, if we take angular distance at a 1 degree. So there will be around 90 parallels in northern hemisphere. Similarly, in southern hemisphere, there will be 90 parallels, total of 180 parallels. Total of 180 parallels. So we have 90 parallels. If we take 1 degree parallels, 2 degree parallels, 3 degree, similarly up to 90 degree parallels. So total will be 180 parallels. Now, one more thing we can see. As we move from the equator towards the pole, the radius of the parallel is decreasing. The radius of the parallel from the equator, it is decreasing. And the length of the parallel is as well decreasing. So maximum radius is of the equator, and the maximum length is of the equator. As you move from equator towards the pole, the length of the parallel decreases. The length of the parallel decreases. So as you move from the equator towards the pole, so length is decreasing. As well, the radius is decreasing. So maximum radius of the parallel is of 0 degree equator, and the maximum length is at the equator. Minimum is at the pole. So minimum radius as well as the minimum length of the parallel at the pole, it will be minimum on both the poles. Now, as we take angular distance of 1 degree each, so length distance between the each parallel will be around 111 kilometers.